Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you some useful tips and tricks for working with links when browsing the web in Safari on your Mac. I'll be looking at how to open up links in new tabs, how you can open them up in new windows, how you can break out a tab into a new window. I'll also look at how we revisit pages, including pages that we've closed, tab groups that we've closed, and how we can share our links and viewed links or web pages that have been shared with us. Now, before we get started, I am showing this using macOS Sonoma, but most of these features, if not all of them, are not specific to macOS Sonoma. Even if you're using an older version of macOS, you still should be able to follow along and use all of these tips and tricks. So why do I mention this? Well, Apple changes how you access them in some cases. So if it doesn't quite look the same and you're using an older macOS version, you may have to hunt around a little bit to see where it is. It might be under a different menu item or it might be under a different name. But for the most part, everything that I'm going to be showing you does work with older versions of macOS. Okay, so with that out of the way, let's get started and take a look at how we work with links or how we browse the web with Safari on the Mac. The first thing we're going to be looking at is tabs. I first want to cover how we work with different tabs. Tabs can be very powerful when you're working or browsing the web. So let's take a look at tabs in Safari. When we're looking at a web page in a single window, this is also what I would consider a single tab. So I'm at Wikipedia here and we have one window here with one browser or one web page open. Now what I can do is I can open this up or open up another page in another tab. When you open up a new tab, we just go up under File here and then we go over to New Tab. What it will do is it'll open up in the same window a new tab. So from here what I'm able to do is go to a different web page. So now what I'm able to do is click on this tab here to go to that tab. And then I can also click on this tab here. Let's go and open up one more. I'm going to use Command T. Command key and the T key. And now we have a third tab. So let's go over to a web page here. We're going to go to CNN. And now I have three tabs open. Now we can easily switch between these tabs just by clicking on them. But we can also use a keyboard shortcut. When I use Command 1, what it's going to do is go to the first tab here. I just hold down Command 1, it goes to the first tab. If I hold down Command 2, it's going to go to the second tab here. And then when I hold down Command 3, it goes to the third tab. We can do this up to 9 tabs, so Command 9 would open up the 9th tab. In addition to that, you can also go back and forth between your open tabs by using a keyboard shortcut. For this keyboard shortcut, you'll use the Command, the Shift key, and then the left or right bracket. These are near the return key, up above the return key on your keyboard. So when you hold those two, Command and Shift, and then press the left or right bracket key, what it'll do is it'll switch between your different tabs. Now, if we want to break out a tab in a separate window, we can do that as well. So it's no longer in a tab, it's going to be a separate window. So right now this is one window with three tabs, but what I'm able to do is drag this tab here, any of the tabs, it doesn't have to be this tab specifically, but all I have to do is just drag this out, and you're going to see that I have a little silhouette here, and now I have two different windows here. So if you need to break out a tab into a separate window, you can do that as well. Another thing we can do is we can merge them back together. To do that, what we do is we go up under Window, and then you're going to see Merge All Windows. What this is going to do is merge all of your windows into a single window with tabs. So let's go ahead and do that. And now we have my three tabs again. Now let's take a look at how we work with links. Links work together with tabs. That's why I wanted to show you tabs first. So when I'm looking at my web page here, all I have to do to open up a link is just click on it. We already know that. You're going to see that I can click on it and it brings me over to that page. But in addition to that, what I'm able to do is use key commands to open it up in another tab or in another window. I use this quite often. So let's say I wanted to keep this window open here, but I also wanted to open up this link here. Well, if I just click on it, what it's going to do is it's going to bring me to that page, and I'm going to lose this page. So what I want to do is I want to open this up in a separate tab. To do that, what we do is we hold down the Command key and then click on it. When I hold down the Command key and click, you're going to see that it opened up in another tab. So now what I'm able to do is just use Command click to go through and open up a number of different pages here. And you can see that they're all open here. Now we can also open them up in a new window instead of a new tab. To do that, what we do is we hold down the Command and Option key on our keyboard and then click on the link. So right now I have one window open with a number of tabs. But now when I hold down the Command and Option key, let's go over to this page here, Command and Option, and then I click on it. What it does is it opens up in a separate window. You can see it's in the back here. So now I want to open up this one in a separate window, Command Option. And it opened up in a separate window. It opens it up in the background there. So now I have three different windows open. I'm going to get tricky here. We can have it open up in a window and bring that window to the front as well. To do that, what we need to do is hold down the Command Option and Shift key. So now, let's say I wanted to open up this page here, and I want it to be in the front. So Command Shift and Option, click on it, and we can see it opened it up, and it's in the front. So let's go ahead and do that one more time. Command, Option, Shift. It opens it up in a new window, and it's in the front. Now, if you don't want to learn those key commands, we can also do this with our contextual menu. If I wanted to open up this link here in a new tab, I hold down the Control key and click, gets to my contextual menu, and then from here I'm able to open this in a new tab. I can also open this up in a new window. So I can choose which one I wanted to open it up in. And when I open it up in a new window, it does bring it to the front. So you don't have to learn all of those key commands if you don't want to. All you really have to do is just go over to your contextual menu, hold down the Control key and click, and from here you can open it up in a new tab or a new window. Now, let's say you wanted to see what the URL is of a web page before you click on it. How can you do that? Well, all you need to do is show the status bar. When we go up under View here in Safari, you're going to see that we have Show Status Bar. I will usually turn this on. So I select this. And now down at the bottom left, you're going to see that we have this little status bar when we place our cursor over a link. So right now, my cursor is over top of a link, so when we go down to the very bottom here, we can see that the URL is showing. If I move my cursor away from that link, it disappears. So it only shows when you're above a link. And then you can actually see where that page is going to go. Like I said, I will usually turn this on. So that's how we work with links. Now let's take a look at our history. Now if you want to go back, let's say we went to a few of these pages here. I'm just clicking on a few pages. And I want to go back. All we have to do is just go up to these two arrows here, and this will take us back and forth within our history. So I just click on it, and it takes me back. I click on the right arrow, and it takes me forward. Pretty simple stuff. Now let's say you didn't want to go back and forth by clicking on that arrow. You can also view your history by going up to History in the menu bar, and then from here what you're able to do is go back in history. We can even go back several days. And we can open up our recently closed web pages and reopen our closed tabs. So if we had a number of tabs open, we can reopen those as well. And this is all located under History. Now, let's say you wanted to go to a web page again. You want to bookmark that. How do you bookmark it? How do you save a web page? Well, basically, there's two different ways to do this. We can save it as a bookmark here, and then it'll show up under our bookmarks. Or what we can do is we can add it to our reading list. And I have a separate video on reading lists, but basically what we're able to do is save it to our reading list. And then once we read that article, it'll disappear from our reading list. Bookmarks here are permanent, while reading lists will disappear after we read it. So it's kind of like a temporary bookmark. So let's just start with bookmarks here. So if I wanted to add this page, I would just go to Add Bookmark. And I go and name it, click on Add, and now it just added it to my bookmarks here. To edit our bookmarks, we can go up under Edit here. And now what we're able to do is move them around. We can create folders in here, arrange or group our different web pages together. And again, these are permanent until we delete them. Now I mentioned we also have a reading list. So let's go back over to that article here. And let's say I wanted to read this later, but I don't want to bookmark it. To read it later, what we do is we go over to our share icon. There's actually a couple different ways to do this. We go to our share icon. This is one way. And then from here, we can add it to our reading list. We can also do this through the contextual menu, but it works a little bit different. Let's say I wanted to add this link here to my reading list. All I have to do is hold down the control key to get to our contextual menu. And then what you're going to see here is add link to reading list. So it's not going to add this page, but what it will add is this link to the reading list. Let's go ahead and do that. And now that is in my reading list. So now how do we access this reading list? Well, what we need to do is go over to our sidebar here. And then you're going to see at the very bottom here, reading list. I select it. And here are all the articles that I read. Now, when you click on these, what it'll do is it'll mark them as read. So then they'll disappear. But there's one thing we have to do. When I swipe down here, you're going to see I can see all of my unread, or I can see all of them. So when I click on all, it's going to show me all of my different articles, even if I've read them. When I click on unread, it's only going to show me my unread articles. So you can see that the list got a lot shorter. Why did it get shorter? Because I read all those other articles. Now, if you want to read them again, you can do that. It does have a history. Like I say, all you have to do is just go back over to all. Again, I do have a separate video on reading lists. Pretty powerful stuff with reading lists. It's like a temporary bookmark. I really like it. So that is how we keep our links organized through bookmarks and reading lists. Another thing we can do is we can easily share web pages that we are looking at. To do that, let's say I wanted to share this page here. Let's go ahead and close my sidebar here. I want to share this web page here. All I have to do is just go over to the share icon. And when I do, I go over and select how I want to share it. I can email the page, I can message it, I can even airdrop the page to someone. Once I do that, it's going to show in their Safari and they're going to be able to read that article. Now, let's say someone shared an article with you. How can you find those shared links? Safari does keep track of articles or web pages that have been shared with you. To view those articles or web pages that have been shared with you, what you need to do is go over to your sidebar again. So I go over to my sidebar. I'm in my reading list here. So I click on this to get to all of my different pages or groupings. And one of them is going to be shared with you. These are all of the web pages that have been shared with me. And then what I'm able to do is open it up. I can even see who shared them with me. So that's how we share our web pages. Not only can we share our web pages, but we can also view all of the web pages that were shared with us. So if you share an article with someone, share a web page with someone, and they can't find it, just tell them to go over to where you can view all of your different groupings and you're going to see shared with you. This is in the sidebar. From there, they'll be able to see those articles or see those web pages. So those are some basic tips and tricks on working with links in Safari on the Mac. Probably my favorite thing or what I use the most is going to be option click. I see a link. I want to read that article, but I don't want to read it right now. I'm still looking at this other page. What I do is I option click on it to open it up in another tab, and then I can go over to that tab. If I know I'm not going to look at it immediately, I'll add it to my reading list, and then I can go and find it later. So those are my favorite or some of my favorite tips for working with links in Safari on the Mac.